two of our major projects, they deal with blast mitigation. So one of the projects is funded by Office of Naval Research. So there we are looking at ship structures and see how these structures will respond to a loading that is from explosives. It's important for us to understand the physical mechanisms of damage that occur in these materials when they are subjected to rapid loadings. Nobody knows how these materials will perform under drastic loadings. Is it delamination? Is it breakage of fiber? Is it breakage of the core material that we are using? So all those things feed into designing a material that will withstand such dynamic loads. So there's a difference between doing experiments and testing. Testing you do of routine things. But when you do experiments, that means you don't know the physics behind it. So we do experiments here, we don't do tests. From the education point of view of graduate students, I think the lab has been very, very successful.
Dr. Shukla is a great mentor. He's extremely knowledgeable and he's extremely well known in his field. He's concerned about helping you learn, helping you do the best that you possibly can.
He's not one of those professors who goes out there trying to make you make it so difficult for you not to learn. He actually makes it simpler, and his work ethic is unbelievable, and he really has a way with people.
But the students find it very interesting, and I never stop these students from trying out. As long as they are safe, you know, safety is of course very important, but as long as it is safe, they can try out ideas. And I know sometimes I think that this idea is not going to work, but I don't want to stop the students, and many times I've been wrong, you know. Research by definition means creativity, you know. If you are not creative, you cannot survive in today's research field just by doing routine work. We are trying to learn new things in every experiment we do. We are trying to see if there is something new in here that we can learn and that we can use.